So we are here for the Mobility Pioneers because we are focusing on the e-mobility and renewable energy sector.
Nice.
And we're here on the panel at 3 p.m.
Fantastic. So it's all happening today. So tell me, what does Kreisel Systems do specifically? Like, what is the structure of your company? What do you specialize in? I know it's yourself and your brothers. It's a family-owned and operated business. But what do you specialize in?
Exactly, we are a family-driven company. We are now about 150 people.
Wow.
We founded the company 3 years ago.
Fantastic.
And we have two divisions. One division is focused on the e-mobility sector.
Uh-huh.
We have founded a really cool battery technology.
Nice.
And the second division is where I am the CEO of, is the ecosystem around the battery for stationary infrastructure and building solutions.
Okay, wow. So what is your background? You're an engineer of sorts at some stage, or how did you get into this whole world?
No, we are not engineers. I'm sure our employees are the engineers.
Yeah,
so we are more consumer
solutions
driven, consumer focused, yes,
yeah.
To think about the future and the environment.
Right, nice. Well, there you go. It's all about sustainability these days, that's for sure. So tell me, you're on a panel. What is the basis of the panel discussion, and you know, what do you hope to get out of it and bring to it today?
We will talk about how the e-mobility will change the infrastructure and change the energy systems, because it's very important. Because the electric car, I mean, the main advantage of the electric car is to run it 100% renewable.
Right.
And
right, of course.
We have to focus on the infrastructure side that we bring the energy also to the cars.
Right. Okay. So who are some of your clients, can you say? I know there's a lot of secrecy in the EV world, you know, but can you name some clients that you kind of supply your batteries to, or at least you're working with? Can you name any, or is it kind of hush-hush?
That's a big problem, because we have signed NDAs with our customers.
Yeah, there's lots of NDAs, right?
But I think you have seen the Jay Leno show.
Yes.
Mr. Arnold Schwarzenegger's G-Wagon. We have converted for him, so it's an all-electric G-Wagon.
Mr. Arnold Schwarzenegger, and he is Austrian, of course, so that kind of makes sense, right?
It's been pushing too many pencils lately. What's going on here?
Well, I'm waiting for you. I'm telling people about your car here. This is a Mercedes that you converted to electric, correct?
Yeah. Well, I didn't do the work,
right.
But Kreisel did. Can you say Kreisel?
Kreisel.
Yeah, Kreisel.
Kreisel.
Okay, now you're talking.
In Austria.
Exactly, in Austria, yes.
Yeah. So they also make the strudel, yeah?
Yeah, they make the strudel and the Wiener Schnitzel.
And the Wiener Schnitzel.
And then ganz gute Schnaps.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You're
but anyway, this is probably the first in the world that a G-Wagon that actually had originally 500 horsepower, but the combustion engine.
Right.
So we took that out. I told them to convert one and to put an electric engine in. 3 months later, now it is an electric engine. It has again 500 horsepower, but the car is lighter. It's now 2,900 kilo. It was with the gas engine 3,400 kilo.
Well, how do you know that?
Well, the way you figure it out, you just go on the knees and you bench press the whole thing.
Oh, you bench press
it? No, absolutely, because I mean, I know the difference of 500 pounds right away.
Right, yeah.
It's for the pectoral muscles, you know, so that you can go like this.
Oh, that's very good.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's very good.
I've been driving this car now for a while, and it is really fantastic.
Can we open the hood? Let's see what it looks like.
Yeah, look at this.
Okay. So does this have regen?
Absolutely. Yeah. It slows the car down right away if you go downhill or if you get to an intersection, and at the same time it charges up the battery.
Okay, very cool. Well, let's take this for a ride.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Exactly.
Kreisel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where we come from.
But absolutely, that's fantastic. Now, how did that come about? Did he reach out to you guys, or you reached out to him, or how did that whole kind of sponsorship, I guess, like how did you get involved in that project?
Oh, there is more business deal, and it's important to have a person like him. He fights against the climatic problems and audience to people with such a person like him. Especially America is probably the biggest market on e-mobility in China. So we come from Europe, so it's good to have him.
Yeah, absolutely. This is fantastic. So tell me kind of what's like the, you know, 6 month, 1 year, maybe even 2 year kind of goals for you guys. What do you see in the future? What are you setting yourselves towards? What's on the horizon?
I think the next step we are going to is in the software step.
Yes.
Everything is looking to the control of energy. And if you have the car and the infrastructure, then you need also the software who controls the energy. 5 years, energy is for free for everybody.
And you love that.
So I think also transportation will go down in price then times 10.
Yes.
And also energy consumption for mobility, for music, for internet will go down 10 times.
Yeah.
So as long as the software can handle everything.
Right. As long as we have the infrastructure and governments are working with private enterprise and vice versa,
Because of this easy to answer, the whole energy system will go decentralized.
Right.
And the cars already are decentralized, and also the stationary energy.
Yeah.
And with the connected machines, connected cars, connected buildings, we will bring down the price for energy consumption very, very fast.
Yeah, well, let's hope so, because that'd be a great thing for all. And renewable energy, we'll obviously be behind that. So, you know, it's a win-win situation. Look, this is a fantastic conference. Tell me, is this your first Mobility Pioneers conference?
Right now, we can focus a little bit more on those events.
Okay, so now you're at the stage where you can attend events like this and get out of the office, so to speak. And so tell me, your headquarters is in the north of Austria or where?
Yes, 40 kilometers from Linz on the border of Czech.
Nice. Who are you seeing as, and I don't want to use the word pioneers, but I will. Who are you seeing as pioneers in the EV space, in the, you know, renewable energy space, or people that are really making it? Because you've got to work together, right? I mean, the thing is with this technology, if there's technology becomes obsolete so quickly, and unless, you know, the end game, the customer, feels like their technology isn't going to be replaced by something else in 2 weeks, 3 weeks time, or tomorrow. So who are you thinking are championing that to make this a really sustainable and viable industry?
I think it's a question of collaborating between customers, startups, and the big companies. If everybody focus on their mission, we need 3 to 5 years to change the whole ecosystem.
Right.
And this is, I think, this is the most hard job, the most challenge to collaborate between those big companies and really amazing fast startups.
Yeah, competing for market share, but you need to work together to make sure that the industry as a whole moves forward, right?
Yes, but right now the industry is looking on proprietary systems, proprietary ecosystems. And we are one company, so we opened it already with the battery technologies, because our customers can run licensed business.
Right.
So the most value they can do themselves.
Right.
And in the system business, we have a disruptive technology, and we offer our technology to be B2B customers.
Yeah.
So everybody will be disrupted by Elon Musk, who's going to Kreisel to have the same technology, functions, and features for their customer solutions. And with the software, we use our open source software. So everybody who wants to produce electric products, and they bring it up to the cloud and to the customer-based solutions, you can use also our software.
Right.
So if somebody take care in this business model, It would be clever to work with us together because he can ramp up very fast his business.
Yeah.
So, and that's, I think, how we should think in the future. And that's the big companies think proprietary and they want to have everything from the cook.
Right.
And we say we open us completely to give it back to the customers. I mean, that's the main thing. It's renewable is one game.
Exactly.
But to make the consumption as cheap as possible and as renewable as possible, that's the main challenge.
Absolutely. No, it's so true. And you've got to, that end game is the customer and their ease of use. And I mean, it's why Apple was so successful, right? Why we hold these in our hands every day. Because
probably there would come other successful pieces, not so proprietary than Apple.
Yeah, of course. Great to meet people.
But I like your dress code. It looks like Mickey Mouse.
Oh, well. I bring a little bit of America to Germany today. Mickey Mouse, I don't know how to take that. But no, I'll take it as a positive. I know. We at ParlayMe, we do things a little bit different. We like to stand out a bit. And we think it's important for entrepreneurs, people like yourself, you know, visionaries, to stand out. And we'd love to hear your story. So thank you for sharing with us. It's really important. Where can people find out more about you guys? I mean, obviously, if they want to learn more about what you're doing or like get involved or reach out, is it kreiselsystems.com or how can people find you?
You will find www.kreiselenergy.com or kreiselsystems.com or kreiselelectric.com or Google it or go to YouTube or we are on any social media.
And you're doing a bit of the speaking rounds at the moment. What's next on your agenda after this conference? Are you doing any other keynotes or panel discussions?
Yeah, there will be very good other events in Austria.
Wait and see. Watch this space, right? Well, pleasure to meet you, Walter. Thank you so much. Enjoy the conference.